Hello and welcome to our second video lecture. In the last video lecture we have discussed our syllabus, and today we are going to start with one of the topics, and that is going to be piecemeal distribution. Already we have started with this topic in our live lectures, so today we are going to see the introductory part of this particular topic. So if anyone might have missed out, can just go through this video and have an idea as to what is piecemeal distribution.
We are going to start with is piecemeal distribution of cash. A very interesting and easy topic, that is piecemeal distribution of cash. Now in piecemeal distribution of cash, how we are going to proceed with, what things will be covered in piecemeal distribution, that we are going to discuss. But before that, in today's lecture, we will try to understand what is the meaning of piecemeal distribution. Now, to understand the meaning of piecemeal distribution, it is very important to once again recall the dissolution that you have already learned in 12th standard. What is dissolution? Now, as I said, our SYBCOM semester 3 is related to partnership firm. So here this piecemeal distribution is of partnership firm, whereas dissolution also I am talking about partnership firm. So what is dissolution? Dissolution is nothing but closing down the business of a partnership firm. Completely is called as dissolution of partnership firm, right? Dissolution means what? Firm is closed down. Now which firm will be closed down? Naturally the firm which was running. Now why the firm has to be closed down? What are the reasons for dissolution? There are n number of reasons why the firm is dissolved. We are not going to discuss the reasons for dissolution. One of the common reasons that is found for dissolution is that firm is running into losses. And that is the reason why the partners decide to dissolve the firm. This is not the reason always, it is one of the reasons why the firm is dissolved. Now let us take an example. Suppose this is the balance sheet of partnership firm. What do you find here? Liabilities and assets. Now as this is the balance sheet of a partnership firm, let us say firm XY. This is the balance sheet of partnership firm XY. The firm has decided to dissolve. That means the firm has decided to close down the business. Now how it will close down the business? Just one fine morning it has decided aaj business band karna hai, business band kar diya. Aisa hota hai kya? No. When the firm has to dissolve, it has to undergo a lot of procedure for dissolution. The basic thing if you see here in balance sheet, these are the liabilities. Agar firm band hona hai, to ye liabilities ka kya karna hai? What is to be done with these liabilities as well as the assets? These liabilities will have to be paid. But how these liabilities will be paid? For that there should be funds. As I said, we are discussing the firm is running into losses and so it has decided to dissolve. So jo firm already loss mein hai, uske paas profit to nahi hoga. So accumulated funds bhi nahi hoga zyada. Even the cash balance will be very less or limited. So ye liabilities pay kahan se honge? From where the liabilities will be paid? या फिर लाइबिलिटी पे ही नहीं करना है, चलो फर्म बंद कर रहे हैं सो वी आर नॉट कंसर्न, हमको लाइबिलिटी पे करने की जरूरत नहीं है. ऐसा होगा क्या? इट इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल. ये लाइबिलिटीज को क्या करना पड़ता है? पे करना पड़ता है. बट एज द फर्म एज आई सेड इज रनिंग इन टू लॉसेज बिकॉज ऑफ विच इट इज नॉट हैविंग फंड्स. कैन इट गो फॉर लोन? लोन लेके ये लाइबिलिटी पे कर सकती है क्या? हु विल गिव लोन टू द डिसॉल्विंग फर्म? No one will give the loan to the dissolving firm, and if at all anyone is ready, it will charge very high interest. So taking loan and then paying off option is ruled out. So option hai nahi. Fir ye liabilities pay kahan se karegi firm? The firm that is going to dissolve will pay the liability by selling the assets. The assets bechenge, usme se jo paisa aayega, that amount it will utilize for making payment of this liability. That is the only option. Now if it is going to sell the assets and then it will have to pay the liability, as I said. Now, selling of this asset at rate which it will receive some money. So, this process of selling the asset and receiving money is called as realization of asset. In accounting terms, it is called as what? Realization of asset. Asset realize hua, uska matlab kya? Asset ko bech ke paisa mil. Some amount is recovered by selling the asset or disposing of the asset is called as realization of asset. So realization meaning should be now clear. Realization of asset ka matlab hai asset bech ke paisa. So what this firm that is going to dissolve will do after dissolution, it is going to sell the asset. And whatever amount it will receive, it will make utilization for payment of this liability. Now, is it possible to sell the asset in a single day? There should be some buyer who is ready to buy. Some proper price should be received for the asset. So, selling of asset is not an easy process. It will take time. It is a slow and steady process. Or we can say the selling of asset is a time consuming process or it is a gradual process. It is not fast and easy process. Ek hi jhatke mein gaye market mein asset becha paisa mila aisa nahi hota hai. It takes time. So selling of asset or realization of asset is what? A gradual process. Again, it is not possible to sell all the assets at a single point of time. Ek hi saath sab asset bechna bhi difficult ho jata hai. इन सच सिचुएशन हर एक एसेट जैसे अच्छा बायर मिलेगा प्राइस मिलेगा विल बी सोल्ड आउट एंड मनी विल बी रियलाइज मीन्स व्हाट एसेट्स कैसे बेचे जाएंगे स्टेप बाय स्टेप एसेट्स विल बी सोल्ड इन पार्ट अगर एसेट्स हम पार्ट में बेचेंगे स्टेप बाय स्टेप स्लोली बेचेंगे तो हमको पैसा भी कैसे मिलेगा पैसा भी हमको पार्ट में मिलेगा कैश विल बी रिसीव्ड इन पार्ट Now as we are going to receive the cash slowly, why we are selling this asset? Because now the firm is dissolved and we want to make payment of liability. For that we want cash, we are selling this asset. Now this cash as I said is going to be received in part, will be received in steps. So how we will make the payment? Shall we wait till the last asset is realized? Realized ka matlab kya? Sold. And then we will accumulate the funds and then only we will make payment. Aisa hoga kya? No. As the firm is dissolved, these creditors to whom the firm has to pay, they will be constantly on the lookout for the firm as to when the firm is having cash and as soon as they come to know if firm has some cash and has sold some asset, they will demand for their dues. So your firm also does not want to keep the burden. So as and when it will receive the cash, it will make the payment. And how it is going to receive the cash? It is going to receive the cash in parts. Why? Because assets will be sold in parts. Assets dheere dheere beche jayenge. To paisa bhi dheere dheere milega. To payment bhi liability ka kaise hoga? Dheere dheere. Payment will be made in parts. This process of selling of assets, receiving that money and making payment is nothing but piecemeal distribution of cash. Assets bech ke kya hoga? Paisa milega. Wo paise se hum kya karenge? Liability pay karenge. Paisa kaise milega? Parts mein. Parts mein means tukdon mein milega. Kaise milega? Piecemeal, pieces mein milega. पेमेंट भी कैसा होगा पार्ट्स में होगा टुकड़ों में होगा पीसेस में होगा सो वॉट एवर अमाउंट इज रिसीव्ड कैश इट विल बी पेड टू होम टू द क्रेडिटर्स फॉर देयर ड्यूज सो दिस प्रोसेस इज नथिंग बट पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ कैश सो वॉट इज पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन नाउ वी विल ट्राई टू पुट द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस थ्री टर्म्स दैट वी आर Discuss now that is dissolution, realization and piecemeal distribution. Now dissolution. What is dissolution? Dissolution of partnership firm means closing down of partnership firm's business completely is called as dissolution of partnership firm. क्लियर डिसोल्यूशन का मतलब क्लोजिंग डाउन ऑफ पार्टनरशिप फर्म्स बिजनेस कंप्लीटली इज कॉल्ड एज डिसोल्यूशन ऑफ पार्टनरशिप फर्म. द नेक्स्ट टर्म दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रियलाइजेशन. रियलाइजेशन ऑफ व्हाट? एसेट्स. सेलिंग ऑफ एसेट्स एंड रिसीविंग कैश इज कॉल्ड रियलाइजेशन ऑफ एसेट. क्या है रियलाइजेशन का मतलब? सेलिंग ऑफ एसेट्स एंड रिसीविंग कैश. एंड देन द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म दैट इज पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. दैट इज द नेम ऑफ अवर टॉपिक इटसेल्फ. पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ कैश. नाउ कैन यू व्हाट इज पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन? इट इज नथिंग बट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ अवेलेबल कैश इन स्मॉल पार्ट्स और पीसेस फॉर पेमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटीज upon dissolution is called as what? Piecemeal distribution. So what is piecemeal distribution? Distribution of available cash. कहाँ से cash available होने वाला है? Assets बेच के जो cash मिलेगा. In cash कैसे मिलेगा? Parts में. In pieces. In small parts or pieces. तो payment भी वैसे ही होगा. पेमेंट करना है पेमेंट ऑफ लाइबिलिटी. अभी करना ये अपॉन डिसोल्यूशन. जब भी फॉर्म डिसॉल्व होता है तब इज कॉल्ड एज व्हाट? पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. तो दिस थ्री टर्म्स शुड बी वेरी क्लियर टू यू इन योर माइंड. पीसमिल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन द मीनिंग द डेफिनेशन यू शुड नो वेरी वेल. बेस्ड ऑन दिस यू माइट गेट सम ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑल्सो. So in today's lecture, what we have discussed the meaning of piecemeal distribution, only the meaning we have discussed today. And we have discussed this term that is realization, and we have also recapped this dissolution that we have learned previously.
So with this, we conclude for this lecture. In the next video lecture, we will take up the next part. Till then, thank you very much and take care.